And we're back. Just waiting for the little sounds to stop. We're gonna head right to the nest, so we can really head to any district and then go from there. So I'll see you guys there. Right. The nest. We are freshly rested and we have 4 camping supplies. We're ready to go. A winding stair hugs the cliffside, providing an impressive view as you work your way higher and higher. Not too far along the path, however, you find your progress interrupted. A large boulder appears to have fallen onto the road from somewhere up above, and it now sits squarely in your way. Let's begin by examining the area. The boulder is nearly flush with the cliff face, preventing you from passing by on that side. Along the edge of the cliff, however, there is a narrow space just wide enough to follow across to the other side. The boulder's landing has crushed the steps beneath it, however. Now that we examine the area, we have another option to try to step around the boulder. We're gonna fall, are we? Try to step around the boulder. Uh-oh. Approaching the boulder, it becomes clear that the lip of rock can barely accommodate a boot. The scattered debris makes every step precarious. A moment's hesitation, and a rock tumbles away under Adair's weight, rolling off the edge. Recovering as quickly as possible, Adair rushes to the other side. Oh no! You hear the echoing clatter of the rocks tumbling down the side of the cliff. The sound seems to stir something overhead. A shadow crosses the path, quick as lightning, and vanishes before you can catch a glimpse of what has cast it. A dragon? But you do see the rapidly growing silhouettes of several more rocks flung down at you from above. Scrambling to action, the party ducks under a small, rocky protrusion along the cliff face, but Durant stumbles and is left just short of shelter. A sudden hailstorm of fist-sized rocks and scattered debris rains down upon them. Battered and bruised, Durant leaps the final distance to safety. After a short while, the thundering rumble of falling stones fades away. Your ordeal passed, you continue your climb, and the rest of the journey proceeds without incident. At last you find yourself at the base of a final twisting set of steps, above which you can see the towering pillars of Hylea's nest. Okay. Awesome. I have reached the peak of the mountain and Hylea's temple. Something very large has been here recently.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Well, let's keep fast mode off. Can we go up here? We can. I'm guessing up there lies the dragon. Let's see what's around here first, though. Barath spell? Another Barath spell? Ooh, what's this? Ooh! The songbird! For what's his name? Down an old song, right? This bird constantly hides its head under its long wings, their light blue feathers mottled by strips of gray and white. Despite the reclusive nature of this species, this cloud singer bursts into elaborate songs when nudged. Return to Dilem. I've gathered 3 special songbirds for Dilem. I should return to him in the old song district of Twin Elms. Yes, if we survive this dragon. Awesome. Good to know. In case we don't survive, let me just save now. I know it's kind of lame. I won't save again so soon. I'm just worried that this last bird might be in a random location. Just in case it is, we'll just save so we have it no matter what. Unless, of course, we can't leave here without encountering the dragon. Two blood moss. Ah, the end, huh? Okay. Nothing else about? You're pretty with the butterflies and all that. The calm before the storm. This is bound to be an epic battle. You guys are current on this right now. I'm like recording this hours before I'm going to upload it. Literally hours. Kind of the extra stuff I'm doing for my 2,000 subscriber special is taking up a lot of time. I'll be glad when I'm done with it. Just the same, I'm enjoying it. The edge of the bones are brittle and blackened. I don't suppose this is anything. If we stand on this, something happens. I'm guessing the dragon's just sitting around here somewhere, and we'll just walk right into him. What about these bones? Oh, hello. Never mind the bones.
My, that is large.
Kana, always a man for understatement. As you reach the summit of the mountain, a gust of wind stirs the air. You hear a noise like the snapping of sails, and the sky is briefly blotted out. A dragon lands before you, or walks over to you, shaking the ground beneath your feet. It draws itself up to its full height and spreads its wings, barring your passage. Its neck, its back, and the ridge of its spine are covered with magnificent plumage. That is a very colorful thing, isn't it? All this metallic blue and purple. It hisses at you, and while the sound is unlike any language you've ever heard, the beast's meaning is utterly clear. Oh, please have voice acting.
Vermin invading my nest.
Awesome.
Threatening my hatchling. You shall feed my young.
It snorts a stream of sulfurous vapor. A small worm crouches in the corner of the temple behind the dragon. Because it's off-screen. You have young here?
I will protect my last hatchling to the death! And that death will be yours, rodent.
The beast snarls, smoke jetting from its nostrils. Hylea is the goddess of motherhood, actually.
And of the sky and all winged creatures. Even my kind know of her.
A low rumble issues from the dragon's throat, and it bristles its feathered crest. Tendrils of smoke rise from beneath its teeth. I'm enjoying talking to the sky dragon. Is that why you came here?
I came to care for my remaining hatchling. My kind requires territory. Few places are safe for our young. This is a lesson that cost me the rest of my brood.
It flicks the tip of its feathered tail. The dragon runs a forked tongue over teeth the size of short swords. A chunk of flesh is lodged between 2 of its cuspids. Is that an option? Can we just tell the dragon to stay and then just leave? Kind of really curious. You and your offspring will kill many if you stay. You have to leave. Trying to be diplomatic. Failing, I know. Yep. Heat from the beast's roar sears your face. My face. It lashes in a flurry of scales and feathers. Well, I'm kind of wondering how long this battle's going to be. Okay. Alright, got some of that going. Holy Radiance. Right? What's it called? Well, yeah. Damaging intellect and perception. Could that work? I would imagine it could make it save. I'm not sure if I want to risk that. So we're down to the next tier. Silent Scream. I don't know if this would work. I mean, the reach on this thing is probably... I mean, it might not even move and still hit us, so... Dimensional shift, actually. Let's do Iron Skin. I'm not sure if that helps against spells. I mean, physical spells, right? Yeah. Iron Skin. I dare. Run up and hit the thing. Start your chance. Alright, here we go. Alright. Okay, he cast that already. Interdiction. Oh, because there's a worm in there? Okay. I guess he cast a stone skin already? Wait. Take a look here. My! It's Palagina for 58 Crush. Sky Dragon, Fear Aura. Oh, there's an... Oh, no, it moved over here, the wormling.
Yeah.
Holy hell! Give us the big one. Durance, Aeloth. Palagina needs it bad, but she's not over there, is she? Where is she? She got knocked down. We need Palagina. Heal yourself. And hurry. And we're out of focus. Theodest, that is, so run forward and... Maybe we just kill the wormling. Got it. Okay. Finish up. Get Palagina. Oh, we killed it! We killed that thing. The wormling, didn't we? Yep. Deedas killed it. Well, that helped a little. Let's do another.
I'm ready.
You are attacking, right? Because she wasn't. Killed her baby. She's pissed now. Regenerate. Suppress affliction. What is he? He's stunned. Okay. Suppress affliction. Oh!
Curses!
Curses, huh? Well, it is injured. Back in the fight. Are we casting that? I hope we are. What else we got? I don't want to use my top healing spells. Armor of Faith. Running out of it. Adair didn't get it, but the rest of us did. Last knockdown. Boom. Well, he's stunned. She didn't cast us, did she? Here we go. Where is he? He can't hit it with a cone. No. I kind of regret taking that cone spell. I like him behind people, so we can, you know, guard him. Noxious Burst. Oh, he's stunned? still casting that? Blessing. He's only up to 2. Is he? Oh, he's in terrified mode. And so is she. I guess that's why she... Yeah. We're all stunned and stuff. No good. Badly injured. Awesome. My God. I can't get us all. Who's this? Durance? Well, Durance is a little more than half injured.
What?
What's it doing? Summoning another one? I guess Kanna is still stunned and that's why he's not... Damn, I want him to summon his worms. Or whatever it is. Yeah, 3 worms. That'd be great. Yeah, recall the agony. Did that work? Missed. Oh my God, she just missed. Okay, well now just hit it again. Pillar of Faith. Can we do Suppress Affliction again? I think we need it.
The Varu beyond sea.
I get screwed up over here. Durance is not injured.
Owen.
Near death. Well, this is doable. This is definitely doable. All we gotta do is keep surviving. I don't know what else any kind of can do. Oh, he's up to 3. It's near death. Just summon skeletons? Or a thunderous explosion? Doesn't hurt for much. Too bad he was stunned for most of the attack. Yeah, why not? Skeletons.
Ah, thank you.
Wait. Stand still.
Oh my God. Let's use our last big heal. Second biggest. Is she dead? She's at 0.
What? Backbone's fear. This.
Is this? Are these things attacking? Attack that thing. Where's the other one? Is it dead already? Or destroyed? I don't know. Backing it, right?
Wait.
Oh my. We did it! Oh my god, it just fell on us. We all leveled up. Haha. I was actually afraid that Aloth was dead forever. Wow, guys. I have dealt with the dragon and its young, and the nest is now safe for Helia's followers. Helia may be willing to grant me a favor in return for my aid. I can pray to her to Tyr Ivran. Holy hell. Dragon meat. Two sky dragon eyes. Well, that makes sense. That has two. Sky dragons are said to have almost supernatural vision, able to pick out the tiniest prey from far above the ground. Though clouded now with death, the iris of this massive eye retains its vibrant green-gold sheen. In my opinion, this should be way more, like, value than 24 copper. Are you serious? Ooh. Go dance, Thunir. Unique Warhammer. Well, we're not going to use this, but just look at it. Attacks can stun on crits. 13 to 18 crush, pierce versus deflection. Fine weapon, so it's plus 4 accuracy and plus 15% damage. Forged by a master smith of the Knights of the Crucible, Godanthanir, God's Thunder, saw greatest use during the War of Defiance. Dedicated to Abaddon and inscribed with his holy symbol, the hammer held devastating power and could leave foes senseless with a single blow. In the thick of battle, warriors would often claim to hear thunderous explosions and witness blinding flashes of light. Many believe the gods themselves disapproved of the fighting and were voicing their displeasure. Yeah, let's level up. Shouldn't take too long. I kind of know what I want, I think. Survival's low for her, so put up. Say no. Yeah. Mostly going athletics and survival, so take a point for survival. Now we have level 11 now. Amplified Wave. Manifest a target ally's mental strengths and projects them outward forcefully, causing a shockwave that inflicts crush damage and knocks any in the area of effect prone. I like that. Foe AoE. Cast it on an ally target. Disintegration. We can take two. So it's more like which one don't we want to take. Burns away the ethereal sinew that holds together the mind, body, and soul of the target enemy, causing it to rapidly take raw damage. Targets to have their endurance reduced to zero disintegrate into non-existence. Ah! That's awesome. Oh, whoa! 232.5 raw damage. Over 20 seconds versus fortitude. I like it. Mind Plague. Destroys an enemy's memory with calculated accuracy, confusing and dazing them before rapidly jumping up to five other enemies. Jumping to up to five other enemies. Air of effect. Foe target plus 5 jump targets. Interrupt. A second. Foe target dazed for 24 seconds. Confused for same. For jump targets, dazed and confused versus will. Okay. That's pretty good, too. I, however, am going to take Disintegration and Amplified Wave. No new talent unlocks. Our almost dead friend. I'm going to rest right here, just in case we come across anything else. Let's take Athletics. Level 6 spells. I always forget which spell we're, like, level we're currently working on. I think this is new, though. Archimere's Capricious Hex unleashes a volatile hex upon enemies in the area of effect, causing them to become either dazed, sickened, or paralyzed, depending on its own mysterious whims. I like that. Dazed, sickened, or paralyzed. Foe area of effect. Okay, so it's either dazed, sickened, or paralyzed for 26 seconds versus will. Pretty good. Chain lightning. Of course, calls forth a tremendous bolt of electricity that arcs directly to a single target and then jumps between up to 6 nearby enemies. Others in the area of effect are not harmed by the arcane lightning. Okay, so as long as you don't aim it on an ally, you're fine, because it's going to jump only to foes. Target 34 to 56 shock. Versus reflex and jump targets. Same. I like it. I like that one. Sitzal's martial power. Caster temporarily sacrifices arcane power for martial might. Wizard gains bonuses to deflection, accuracy, might, constitution, and dexterity, but becomes unable to cast spells or switch grimoires for the duration of the spell. Nah, enough of that. Death Ring. Calls a black ring of necrotic energy into being that spreads out in all directions, causing corrode damage to enemies it touches, and potentially destroying those with low endurance. ...7.13-meter radius. Foe AoE 34 to 50 corrode. Destroyed versus fortitude. Nice. So I wonder if we can cast another spell, you know, from some, you know, either one of our three casting powers, or possibly even Kana, to lower someone's fortitude, and then cast that. Just destroy things. I like that. So far, Death Ring and Chain Lightning. I'm really like, you know, I know I should focus more on crowd control spells, but I just like the physical spells. I can't help it. Gaze of the Adrakan gives the caster the mystifying gaze of the Adra creature that provides the spell's namesake, petrifying enemies within the area of effect. These are some powerful spells. 8-meter range, area of effect 2.14-meter radius. Area of effect for foe petrified over 7.8 seconds. I mean, granted, that's a long time in a battle. I'm going to get Chain Lightning and Death Ring. Next time I'd probably get Gaze of the Adrakan. Level 2 spells can now be used per encounter. Awesome.
Hey.
Hey, hey. Get survival up. Another fighter ability. Oh, I like that vigorous defense. Confident aim. Plus 10 accuracy. Guardian stance. Into the fray, unbroken. Nice. I like the unbroken. The fighter refuses to be vanquished. After being knocked out, the fighter stands back up with a portion of his or her endurance healed and temporary bonuses to all defense and damage reductions. It's a good, you know, just in case thing. I could see it only happening if he was the last one, but no, just in case. Revive with 124 endurance, plus 5 damage reduction. Now all we need is give him an ability or item that can resurrect a fallen comrade, and then he could get up and use that, or cast that, whatever. So yeah, he gets back up with 124 endurance, plus 5 damage reduction, plus 10 deflection, plus 10 fortitude, 10 reflex, and 10 will, all for a half a minute, 30 seconds. Do that. Endurance. Of course, we're going to increase your mechanics. And that's it for him. Level 2 can now be used per encounter. You got new spells? I believe you do. Spark the Souls of the Righteous. Ignites a powerful zeal that allies within allies that manifests an aura that shocks any enemies near them. Allied AoE. Okay. Foe AoE for 37.5. Okay, cool. 14 to 24 shock. Pretty cool. Prayer against treachery. Friendly AoE plus 50 defense against charmed attacks. Minus 10 second for charmed duration. Same for dominated. Galvanizes the devotion of the party, granting bonuses against attacks with charm or dominate afflictions, as well as reducing the duration of any such afflictions already on the target. Very specific, but I'll have to keep that in mind. Minor intercession. 29.5 endurance, or adding actually. Minus 5 duration of active hostile effects. Well, it's an area of effect, so it gradually calls upon the aid of the priest god, restoring endurance and reducing durations of negative effects for all allies in the area of effect. Not sure how effective that is. Depends on how long the duration is. Does it even... I didn't see where it said. Speed, fast... Doesn't say, like, how long this goes on for. Area of effect, and then 29.5 endurance over how, what length of time. Obviously, the lengthier it is, the better. Crowns for the faithful. 10 meter range. Friendly AoE, plus 6 perception, plus 25 resolve, plus 6 intellect. See here, they tell you 4. 37.5 seconds. Crowns allies in the glory of the priest god, imbuing all allies in the area of effect with bonuses to reception, intellect, and resolve. And we have finally Cleansing flame. Ooh, look at all those effects. 10-meter range plus 3-meter jump. Foe target plus 2 jump targets. Foe target takes 109 burn damage over 6 seconds. I'm just averaging. Minus 5 duration of active beneficial effects for 6 seconds. Plus 100% damage over time tick rate for 6 seconds. Foe jump targets. Pretty much the same. Yeah, same. The priest hurls a ball of holy fire at the enemy that purges its protections and speeds its doom. Does continuous burn damage for 5 seconds and accelerates the timer for all beneficial effects on the target, except heals as well as those of any continuous damage effects, leaps up to 2 additional nearby enemies. Cool. Palagina, and a long episode. Plus, we're going to explore the rest of this area, however big this is. I don't think it's that big, so. Well, we can't raise athletics anymore. Survival. I don't know if it can go higher than 11. Got another ability. Inspiring Triumph. I can read all this, but. It's kind of similar to what she already has. Zealous Charge. Sworn Enemy. Oh, I like this. Granting accuracy and damage bonuses against the... Okay, 3 per rest. You can only take 1. Snuffing out active beneficial effects on a single foe. Improving deflection of an ally. Righteous Soul. Bonus of defense against poison, disease, charmed, dominated, frightened, terrified. That's good, actually. She'll be free to, like, lay on hands and stuff. And raise people from the dead. I think I might take that. Attack speed. Let's take Righteous Soul. Because in times like this, this battle, where it took her forever to, like, do anything because she was stunned. Well, this doesn't help against stunned, but helps against a bunch of others, so we'll take that. And finally, Kana. Survival. What do we got here? A burning effect on all ally weapons. Burn damage. Hmm. 13.8 seconds. I guess every time they hit. 7 men onto the deck they went. Allies gain a bonus to freeze and shock damage reductions and a bonus to defense against prone. Been knocked prone a few times. What about Silver Knight shields broke both arrow and blade. Increases deflection of allies. Plus 10 deflection. Yeah, do that.
Following your lead.
How do I add that? I forgot how I add this. Oh wait. Okay. Here we go. What was it then? That. Let me just rest real quick. Alright, that was quite a hardy battle, and now we're full strength again.
As you say.
I do say.
I'll see what I can find.
Let's look for secrets. Reveal your secrets. Oh, look at this. That's its nest itself. This is stealing? We killed the thing. Willbreaker? No, we got a topaz. A diamond. Have you ever found a diamond? This most colorless stone is popular for its shimmering look, but is not especially rare and can be purchased at reasonable prices in most areas of the world. Hmm. These dragon tears, right? Andra's tooth? Yeah. Never mind. Well, we stole from it after killing it. Interesting. We learned Bewildering Spectacle. Now if we'll ever use it. Oh, I meant to click closed. Call to Slumber. Causes a group of enemies to momentarily fall asleep, giving going prone for a short duration. 13 seconds. I can't see how it'll cost money to learn spells from this thing. We're up here by ourselves. Why are we throwing money into it? Oh, this is that spell we couldn't take. Well, now we got it anyway. And the Gaze of the Adragon. Cool. I know we haven't put it in a spell book, but can we? Do we have room? Well, we don't have 7th level and we're full here. Okay. More goodies here. Pensieve Misere. +3 might. The story goes that this ring belonged to the Seeker of Balance, a cipher assassin of the Order of the Black Stone. He was captured in an attempt to kill a duchess in Old Valia, and while waiting execution, he channeled his soul into the ring. The ring was then taken by one of the guards, who, upon wearing it, was possessed by the Seeker. The guard, he completed the assassination of the Duchess. Over the years, the ring lost its power to possess, but remained a formidable item. This tarnished old ring isn't much to look at. By night, however, the mark of the Order of the Black Stone glows from the band. Cool. I don't think we're going to have anyone put it on yet, but... However dare hold on to it. I still think we have 5 fingers in each hand. We should be able to wear 10 rings. That'd be cool. That's it. That is it for this zone. We're done. Well, that wasn't that hard at all. I thought that was going to be incredibly painful. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.